Dietrich Fischer-Dieskau, a legend in his own time, and in opera, always profoundly searching for lifelike subtle complexities beneath the surface of his roles. Hans Sachs, in Wagner's Die Meistersinger von Nuremberg, was one of his very most famous ones.
Quite astonishing, because Wagner identifies himself very much with Sachs. And this sort of resignation Sachs has, one doesn't think in the personality of Richard Wagner. He is seen as the egoist and conqueror from A to Z, you know, to build his own opera house, to have the money that he was able to, and so on. But there were other sides also in this man. And these are perfectly expressed in this part of Sachs.
Hans Sachs sacrifices his love for the beautiful young Eva because he knows that he's too old for her, and he wants her to marry the man that she's in love with, who is very much in love with her, Walter. But that takes some very clever arranging, as he has to convince the Meistersingers that Walter can be admitted to their guild, as Eva's father has stipulated that only a Meistersinger and the winner of the Midsummer Day Song Competition can wed her. The Meistersingers have rejected Walter, but Sachs strongly believes in him as an artist as well as the ideal husband for Eva, and after a lot of artful planning, he succeeds brilliantly. So he's the hero of the opera. And in many interpretations, he comes across as a man whose strength of character enables him to overcome his conflicts without too much difficulty. But with Dietrich Fischer-Dieskau, it's nothing like so straightforward.
I think the neighborhood of sarcasm and wit and being sharp remarks all the time and to be melancholic and thinking about the world and all the evil things in the world. And the van, überall van. This neighborhood of these two things bring this result in a very almost sinister figure, if we want. On the other hand, he has wit enough to be above the things, above these surroundings all the time, all this durcheinander.
Even then, Dietrich Fischer-Dieskau surprised his audiences at the end of the opera when the crowd acclaims Hans Sachs and Eva removes the winner's crown from Walter's head and places it on Sachs's head in celebration of what he has accomplished.
I think I had the right idea at the end of this Berlin first performance I sang. I just turned the back to the whole mass of people on stage and went out. And the director said, "My goodness, that's the idea." Because that I needed. Somehow he wants to be for himself, you know. Also out of some very bitter thinking about Eve, about this whole thing which happened before in the Schusterstube and.
Wer heil, wer heil.
Dietrich Fischer-Dieskau sings Hans Sachs in Deutsche Grammophon's recording of Wagner's Die Meistersinger von Nuremberg, conducted by Eugene Jochum.